Hey guys, here is another edition of Nerd E playing the solo game of Terraforming Mars. At this point, I've already drawn my two corporation choices. I've got all my stuff set at zero, getting ready to figure out which of the 10 cards I'm going to keep. I've already drawn them. I've already placed out the cities and the greenery tiles for the non-playing player. We're all ready to go, so we're going to start now. So I'm going to start looking at the different things. First of all, my two corporations. This one's going to be really good for power cards and gives me energy to start with. And of course, Eagle Line is all about getting those plant tiles down and getting as many of those leaves as possible. So let's just look and see what we have here. Business Network Action, look at the top card. Another buy to discard it. That might be good to be able to go through a lot of cards and look to see a lot of cards. So I might hold on to that just to get as many cards as I can into my hand as possible for the game. The Titanium Mine is not a bad card. Going to give me some titanium. We'll see if we have any reason to have titanium. Algae definitely only works when we have the five ocean tiles down, but again, going to give us a lot of plant life, which can give us a lot of points and also gives us that oxygen we need. The mining expedition, not bad here. Get two steel, be able to jump the oxygen up one. Would take away two plants from other players, but there aren't other players. Power plant is going to be one of those energy cards that we would like for Thorgate and also would give us some more energy to produce. Geothermal power is going to be another one of those great energy cards that we could utilize and also give us more energy produced. The higher graders would give us two steel or two or three money, which is not bad. We're stealing it from nobody, but it's still good to have because it's only going to cost us $4 for two steel, which is going to be equal to $4. So really, it's not that great in this game if you do the math on it, because it's three cards to keep the card, one card to pay for it, and $1 to pay for it. So it actually loses a dollar if you take it for cash, and it's worth the same amount if you do it for steel. Stream Cold Fungus, we can do an action to get a plant or two microbes to another card, which would give us more plant life if we wanted to go that route. Towing Comet, which is going to give us a lot of different stuff. And we have the Import of Advanced GHG, which is going to give us the ability to do a lot of heat. I like Ecoline a lot, but I feel like it's easy and very usable for a lot of different situations. I think Thorgate is our best bet in this game because of how we're already going to have two of these cards we can get the cheapness from because of the discount. We also have a lot of good amount of money we're going to have. We're actually going to have a lot of energy production, which is going to give us a lot of heat production, which is what we need to really get this game won. So I'm going to choose Thorgate to keep as my base excuse me, corporation. Sorry, I got a frog in my throat there, guys. And because I'm keeping that, I, of course, am going to keep the two energy cards. I would like to keep the titanium mine because I have two titanium-utilizing cards that I want to keep. Algae is good, but not necessarily what we need in this game, especially because it takes so long to do. Extreme Cold Fungus is also nice, but again, may not be what we need. Hired Raiders already discussed the benefits and detriments of that card. The Mining Expedition is a good way to get us some cheap oxygen. And the Business Network, the great thing about it, like I said, is being able to look at the top card and either buy it or discard it. Now, buy it or discard it means put it into your hand for $3. So I still have to pay to put it in my hand, but I'd still be able to get a lot more cards looked at during the game, which is going to be something I need to do. So in that case, we're keeping seven cards. So if we keep seven cards, which we're just going to go ahead and subtract that from our total here, we're only going to get 21 less than that. So we're going to get $27 cash into our starting amount. So we'll go ahead and take that $27. We're also going to bump one on the energy production because we're starting with energy production. Unfortunately, we don't do any production before the beginning of the first round, but that's okay. We're going to have energy from then on. And now the choice becomes what do we want to do and when do we want to do it. Of course, we would like to do the mining expedition, which is going to give us two steel, use the steel to get the titanium mine, or use the steel for the power plant, but it's already going to be a discount of -3, which is also great. And we can also do the geothermal power, which is going to be a discount as well. So let's just do the math on this. If we have $12 here, and we have 27 total, that'll give us 15 left over. If we play this guy for just $1, we'll have 14 left. This is going to cost us 8. So we will have 6 left. And if we use some of the steel for this, we'll be able to play it as well. We'll be able to get all of those cards out, start doing our production of titanium, and be ready to do our towing comet and import of advanced GHG second round. We may be able to get the business network out if we're able to do this correctly, so we're going to see if we can do that in the math on that first. But first things first, we're playing the mining expedition. It's going to cost us 12 of our dollars. We're going to increase the oxygen up 1. Which is going to give us 1 on our terraforming rating. We're going to take away 2 plants from the other players, but again, we don't have another player, so it's okay. We get 2 steel as well, though. That was an event, so we're going to put that face down over here, and we're just going to keep those over here. Next thing we're going to do, we're going to play the power plant here, which is going to cost us just $1 because it's 4 minus 3 because of the tag. So we're only going to pay $1 for it. And we're going to bump our energy up one more time to 2. If we play the geothermal power, it's going to cost us 8, but we're going to spend 4 of that, so it's only going to cost us $4 cash to play the geothermal power. It's going to give us 2 more production on our energy, so we're up to 4. We have $10 remaining, which these 2 cards together will cost us 11. Which is unfortunate, not quite enough, but that's okay. We're definitely going to do titanium mine first because we want to be producing what we can as quickly as possible. So we're going to spend 7 of our dollars to play a titanium mine down, and now we go up 1 on our titanium production. That's all we can do this round, but I do think we did a lot of good this round. So we're going to end the round, bump up the round marker to the 2. We're going to produce 1 titanium and 4 energy. And we're going to produce $15 because we are at 15 on the score tracker here, and we have 0 on our current marker here. Now, we will be drawing 4 more cards now for the beginning of the second round. We have lichen, which will give us 1 production of plants, which we're not doing much production of plants, but that's going to be good, and we might need it, so we might hold on to it. The virus is only negative towards other players, which again, we're not playing with other players, so it's not beneficial during this game. We have industrial microbe is going to give us more energy production, and also it's going to give us some steel production, which is going to be good. We might hold on to that. And release of inert gases is going to give us basically 2 bumps on the track here, which we're going to be producing money from it. 1 on round 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 times. So that would be worth $24. It's going to cost us $17 to get it in our hand. I don't think the initial cost of that is going to be worth the price we're paying for it. So we're not going to hold on to that or the viruses. We want to be able to play business network as soon as possible. So we want to have at least $4 left over, which we have $18. If we keep the industrial microbes, which is going to give us more steel production or some steel production, but also energy, which we're not going to be able to use all the energy we have, and I don't want to produce too much energy for no reason. I'm not going to hold on to the industrial microbes. I do think it may be beneficial to hold on to the lichen because I'll be able to, for only $10, basically 3 to keep the card and 7 for that, to be able to produce some plant life, which we may need at the end of the game because we're not producing plants on any of the rest of our cards or any of the rest of the things we have going for us. But I also want to be able to do as much as I can this next round, namely playing this for 4, this for 9 minus 3 because of our titanium we have produced, and also potentially drawing a card and keeping it with that. So if we keep no cards, we would be spending $13 minus 3, so $10 would be spent. We would have 8 leftovers. We'd have $8, which would cost us 3 to keep the card in our hand, and $5 after that. Knowing that, we can still afford to keep one of these 2 cards because of the abilities that we're talking about and the amount of money we're going to save. So the question is, which of these 2 cards is more beneficial to our game plan at this time? And I think the more beneficial card for us in this case is going to be probably the lichen, since we already have production of energy. So we're going to only keep 1 card and pay $3 to keep it. We cannot play lichen yet because we don't have the temperature up to where it needs to be yet, but that's okay. We're going to pay $4 for the business network, playing it down, losing $1 in our money production, but that's okay. We're not too worried about that currently. The other thing that we're going to be doing, sorry, I'm just reshuffling and reordering where everything looks on the board because it was kind of messed up there. We're going to go ahead and do the action now. Look at the top card. And it is Permafrost Extraction for $8. We can put up Ocean Tile down, which we're going to keep. So we're going to spend $3 to keep that into our hand. So we're going to spend our 10, get back 7. We can't play it yet, of course, because it needs to have -8°C. But we can play from our hand the import of Advanced GHG, which is going to cost us 3, 5, which is 8, and then 9. So $9 total, 3 of that coming from the titanium. It is an event, as you can see. So we're going to bump up our heat production up by 2, and we're going to flip this card over. That's all we can do this round. The good thing here is, though, our energy becomes heat, and we're going to produce from then on. But we're going to go ahead and flip the turn marker up to 3. We're going to produce 1 titanium, 4 more energy, and 2 heat. We also are going to be only getting $14 this time because of the -1 that we have on our money tracking. But we are at 15 points on the terraforming rating. We're going to draw 4 cards, and we're also going to clear off this action key that we used. Mars University, we can, when you play a science tag, you can draw a card, and you can discard a card from your hand to draw a card. So that's kind of like swapping cards out, which is not necessarily great, but it could be okay. We'll see. Ants is going to be all about making points, and we're not worried about that. We want to win the game, not make the points. Points are a secondary thing. And another way to put the ocean tiles down, which might be a good thing. So we're going to hold on to that card for $3. And currently we have $13 cash. We're going to go ahead and do the action of our card to draw a new card to see what comes out, to see if we want to keep it. It is Nitrophilic Moss, which is going to give us production and plant life. We would have to lose 2 plants, though, which currently don't have any plants. So we can't do that until we can lose those plants. But it may be something we want to hold on to. Question is there any card that we can play right now with our $13 and $3 there? So that's $16 we would have. We can't play any based on the temperature that it currently is in the game. We cannot play the Toe and Comet just yet. I think it's going to be beneficial for us to go ahead and keep the Nitrophilic Moss, pay $3 to put it into our hand. And at this point, we cannot do the energy or the heat production into turn it into jump on the temperature track, but we're going to end the round, bumping the round up to 4, pushing our energy over to heat, producing 2 more heat. And I threw that on the floor, of course. We are going to get 4 more energy. Got a lot of cubes there. We'll be spinning them soon. 1 more titanium. And we get 1 minus our 15, so we get $14 again to start the round with. And we'll draw 4 more cards. We have Methane from Titan, which is going to give us the ability to get 2 bunch of bumps on both of these tracks, which is pretty good. We have Power Infrastructure, which is an action, spend any amount of energy that we have to gain that much money, which is not bad at all. And we'd also be able to get it for $1 once we paid the 3, of course, to get it into our hand. It's only going to cost us $1 because of our bonus here. And because we're producing a lot of energy, if we have enough heat towards the end of the game, we could just make that money, which is a good thing. We have Shuttles here, which is any time we do anything in its space, but we can't do it until we're 5% of oxygen, which is going to be a while. We also have Miranda Resort, which is only going to look at our Earth tags, which we don't have but one of yet, which is not really worth it right now. So we're going to keep these 2 cards. We're going to pay $6 to keep them, which is going to be just 11, and then get back a 5. We have these cards in our hand now. We're definitely going to go ahead and play this guy here, which is only going to cost us $1 to play because of the discount. We're also going to do our action to draw a card, look at it, and see if we want to keep it. And Lava Flows, I think we will keep it. That's going to be a way to get the energy or the temperature up quickly. So we're going to keep that. So we're going to pay $3 in cash to keep that into our hand. We have $14 remaining currently. And it seems that we don't have anything else we can do from our hand currently at this time. But we can spend 8 of our heat. Which we'll do so now to bump the temperature up 1, which will bump our terraforming rating up 1. So we're now at 16. We could do the action, which would convert this into money, with right now we have 14 bucks cash. If we got up to the 18 bucks, we would be able to do the lava flows now, which we will do. So we're going to do the action, spend any amount of energy to gain that amount of money, which is 4 energy becoming 4 money, which means I have now 18, which I will spend all of that money on right now. 4 lava flows, which we will get the lava flows tile from the board. And I have to put it on Tharsis Stolas, Acreus Mons, Pathanus Mons, or Arcea Mons. And we are going to put it on... I think we're going to put it on Pavonus Mons, which is going to give us titanium and a plant. And it'll give us 2 bumps on the temperature track, 1, 2, giving us 1 more heat production, and 2 bumps on our terraforming rating. We now have 4 heat. We have 9 bucks worth of titanium. Again, not enough to do a whole lot, but we are at the 24 degree threshold, which is going to be good for our lichen, which we'll be able to play soon. And we just need to have 7 bucks, which we don't have currently. We're going to end the round. We were action cubes, bumping up to round 5. We're going to produce 4 energy again. 3 heat this time. And 1 titanium, and minus 1 of our 18, so $17 in cash. And draw 4 more cards. We have the terraforming Ganymede, which is going to just give us points for each of our tags of Jovian, which we're not going to keep. We have Moss, which is going to take away a plant and give us a plant production, but it requires 3 oceans. We're not going to keep, I don't believe. Rad Suits is just going to be points and a money, but we need 2 cities on the board. There are 2 cities in play, so we could jump our money up by 1 and get a point for that. That might be beneficial because it's going to cost us 9 total, 3 to put it in our hand, 6 to play it. And we have about 10 more rounds left, which that's going to pay for itself barely. I don't think we're going to keep it. We have the water splitting plant. If we have 2 oceans out on the board, we'll be able to spend 3 energy to bump the oxygen 1 step for free. And we have energy production. That might be something we want to hold on to. I think we will actually keep that card. We'll spend $3 to keep that card, spending our 5 and getting $2 in change back. First thing we're going to do this round is use our action card to draw the top card, see if we want to keep it or not. And it puts a microbe. Every 3rd microbe, we get to plus another one. We're not going to keep that card. It'll just be discarded. Don't want to spend the 3 bucks to keep it in our hand. We have lichen. We definitely want to play now for 7 bucks. We'll play the 10 and get 3 bucks and change back. We bump our production of plant life up 1. We have 2, 4, 6, 7 heat. We have 4 energy. We have $12 worth of titanium. And 2, 4, 6, 7 bucks. We have 19 bucks worth of money if we were to use a titanium requiring card, but none of them are going to be worthwhile. We don't have enough money in cash to pay the money water spitting plant. We also don't have the two oceans. And we cannot play anything else based on the needs of the cards. What we can do, though, is convert all 4 of these into 4 bucks, which gives us 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, $11 plus 12, which is now 23, to play Towing the Comet that way, which is what we are going to do. Spending all this titanium, all of that money, to get the Towing the Comet, which is going to give us 2 plants. It's going to give us 1 jump on the oxygen, which is going to bump our terraforming rating up. We're going to place 1 ocean, which is also going to place our terraforming rating up 1 more. We must decide where to place this ocean tile. I think the best course of action for us in this case is to place this ocean where we can get probably more cards at this point. So we're going to place it here to get 2 more cards directly into our hand, which is the Rad Chem Factory and the Cupola City, which is probably one that we're not going to hold on to, but we may. We'll see. We played Towing the Comet. We now flip it over as an event. We look and see what we have on our board, which is not enough to do anything. We will remove this action cube. Again, we did an action here, so we would have had an action cube there, but we remove both of them now. We bump up to round 6. We make 1 titanium. We make 3 heat. We make 4 energy. and we make one plant. So we're starting to make plants, which is good. We're also going to get 20 minus $1, which is going to be 19 bucks. And four new cards. Moho area, which is going to give us four heat production and be a very big benefit to get our temperature track up. Lake Marineris, which is going to give us obviously ocean tiles for a very cheap price, but we have to have the temperature up high, which is okay. Anytime we do the standard projects, we get $3 back. And greenhouses for every city, we get a plant life. We're not going to hold on to that. Standard projects, I don't think we're going to hold on to that, the standard technology, I mean. But I think we will hold on to both of these because they work pretty simultaneously together. So we're going to pay $6 to keep both of those cards. Now the question is, what can we do and what will we do? I think what we want to do is go ahead and get rid of this couple of city card. I'm never going to use it, I don't think. And we're going to get $1 for having discarded that. The Radkin factory as well. I don't feel like I want to use that card. Although it will give us two bumps on the terraforming rating, we'll have to lose one of those energies, which we're utilizing that more often because we're able to make it into cash anyway. I think I'm going to discard it to get another dollar. We currently have 15 bucks in cash. We have $3 in titanium, which is not enough to do our methane from Titan, nor do we, but we do have the oxygen where we need to be. We could turn our four energy into money, which we will do, unless we find a better course of action, which we will look around the board first for that. I think that we definitely want to try and get the Mohole area out, but we can't do that with what we currently have. We have $19 when we need 20. Nothing we have is utilizing our energy card reduction in price. So we're gonna go ahead and do the draw card and see what we get out of it first. Breathing filter is not gonna be worth it. We're just gonna discard that. Let's go ahead and bump the temperature up one for 8 heat. Sometimes it's a little hard to grab these little cubes with my one hand since I'm filming with the other, but that's okay. Bumped our terraforming rating up as well. We have no ability to do lake. We cannot do the permafrost yet. We cannot do the ice cap melting. We cannot do the moss. We cannot do the water splitting plant. We don't have enough money to do and can't do the methane from Titan. We cannot do Mohole. We are going to end the round. But first we're going to convert this energy into money because we're going to need that money. And we're going to now bump the round tracker up to 7. We're going to produce heat. We're going to produce energy. We're going to produce a plant. We're going to produce a titanium. And we're going to make money of 20 bucks this time, 21 minus 1. Now we have a lot more money. We can start doing some of the bigger cards that we had from the beginning of the game in our hand. We have Ironworks, which would allow us to bump up the temperature and get a steel, which is great, but I'm already using that money for cash, or that energy for cash, and I might be spending that energy here soon for other things. The Zeppelins, not bad, get some cash for each city, but there's only two. Cloud Seeding, not bad, but it's only two plant production, and I think we're going to be able to do the oxygen okay. We have Artificial Photosynthesis, we can bump our energy production up twice, and we'd be able to, or we'd be able to do that. I think we'll be doing the Artificial Photosynthesis, keeping that card, spending 3 to keep it. Then we're going to put that in our hand, go ahead and do our action of drawing the top card, decide if we want to keep that or not. I think we will keep that Arctic Algae because we can still do it. The temperature is not too high. We're going to be placing all of the oceans out at some point during the game. I think it's going to be beneficial. We just need to make sure we play Arctic Algae before we place any more ocean tiles down. Right now we have $33 in cash. We have $6 worth of titanium. Let's see what we can do. We can very easily do the methane from Titan with purely cash, or we can spend 6 of our bucks in titanium, which we will do, and then 22 bucks in cash to play methane from Titan. What that's going to do is bump our heat production up 2, and we're going to bump our plant production up 2. We all now have $11 in cash, which we can do the Artificial Photosynthesis. Because we can do that now, we can bump our energy up for the next round coming. I think that's what we will do. We will put all of these into money. We will spend $12 to get 2 more energy production, up to 6 now, from the artificial photosynthesis. We've done the action we were converting with. We have $3 in cash, not enough to do anything else. Don't have enough temperature or heat to do the temperature. We don't have enough plants to do any more of those. We're going to end the round now. We're going to round 8. We are going to remove our action cubes. Take a titanium. Take 3 plants. Take 6 energy. And take 5 heat. We're also going to take 20 money. And draw 4 more cards. We have livestock, we have Trans Neptune Probe, local heat trapping, and Noctis Farming. Noctis Farming is going to be not that great right now. Trans Neptune Probe is just bonus points. We're also not going to keep the livestock, and I don't believe we're going to keep local heat trapping because it's going to spend 5 of our heat to do so, and we're not going to keep any of those cards, making it a little bit easier for our decision making process. First thing we'll do is we're going to do our action to draw a card to see if we want to keep it. Each of our titanium and each of our steel is going to be worth 1 extra, but it's going to cost us too much. There's not enough time left in the game. I'm not going to keep that. I am going to go ahead and play Arctic Algae, however, which is going to cost us $12. So whenever an ocean tile is played, we'll be able to get 2 plants out of it. We have $11 in cash, but we also have 6 energy. We would like to get another ocean down, but we cannot do that just yet. We want to go ahead and get all of that $6 into money for the next round. We're going to spend 8 of our heat to bump the temperature up to produce 1 more heat each round and bump our terraforming rating up. We now have $17, which is not enough to do any of the cards we currently have in our hand. We're going to end the round unless we have enough plants, which we have 3, 6, 8. We do have enough plants. So we are going to go ahead and make a greenery tile. This greenery tile is going to bump the temperature up and bump up our terraforming rating. But this tile needs to go next to where we already have something. And the only thing that we have right now is the lava flows. So we're going to go ahead and place this tile here to get 2 more plants currently. And we are going to end the round, remove our action cubes, bump the round marker to 9. We're going to make 3 more plants, make 6 energy, as well as make 6 heat, make 1 titanium, and 23 minus 1 is $22. And we are going to draw cards. We have a capital, which requires 4 oceans, and we're not going to keep that. We have the windmills, which requires 7 oxygen, which we don't have. We have natural preserves, which requires less than 4, which we do have, but it's going to cost us too much. And we have the protected valley, which is going to allow us to play a greenery tile, greenery card down, a tile down, and we'll be able to get $2 of money production for the last 5 production phases, which is going to be $10 total, which is going to cost us 13. Yes, that's worth it, because the cost of placing a greener tile for cash is the same as this card is costing us, so might as well keep it, so it's $3. We have $36 in cash. We don't have any cards that require titanium, but what we are going to do is draw the top card to see if we want to keep it. It is a bunch more energy, which we don't really want or need right now, so we're not going to keep that. We are not able to do any of the ones requiring temperature. We're not able to do any of the ones that are requiring oceans, but we would like to try and play an ocean tile down as quickly as possible. So what we are going to do is pay the premium, which is $18, to do the standard project of placing an ocean tile down. We're going to place that ocean tile down, and we're going to place it let's place it up here and get 2 steel. That will bump our terraforming rating up 1. We also placed an ocean tile, meaning we get 2 plant life out of it. We have 2, 4, 6, 7 now. We also now have 2 plants, which we're able to utilize and spend. Now because we have it, we can do the card we have here. We have $4 Of that, we need $8 more. We'll spend the rest of ours in cash to do our water splitting plant. We spend 3 energy to get 1 oxygen bump, which we're going to do now. So we're going to spend 3 of our energy to go up 1 on the oxygen, go up 1 on our terraforming rating. And we now have $10 in cash. We have $6 in titanium. We have enough heat. We're going to go ahead and produce or use the heat to go up 1 on the temperature track, making us go to 26. We unfortunately don't have enough plant life. But can we get $20? We cannot. For the boho area, we don't have enough for the protected valley. We don't have enough oceans for the nitrophilic moss. But we will do the action of bumping this. We're going to bump 1 of our dollars, just 1, up to energy to dollars, because we're going to have 2 bumped over, and we're going to do the heat again next round. So we're going to go ahead and end the round, remove our action cubes, bump up to round 10. We're going to make 1 titanium, 3 plants, 6 energy, and that energy that was there goes over to heat, making it now have 8 in it because we produced 6. We're going to make $25, draw 4 more cards. Physics complex is just kind of a way to get some points. We're not going to hold on to that. Gene repair, we're not going to hold on to that. We don't have enough science tiles or cards anyway. Commercial district, we're not going to keep. And asteroid mining consortium, it's not bad, but we don't have any cards that require titanium, so we're not going to keep it. First thing we're going to do is do our action to draw a card to see if we want to keep it. It is ore processor, basically doing the same thing as the water splitting plant, but for 1 more, but also giving us the titanium. Again, we don't really need that. We don't need titanium. We have titanium. We're not spending it on anything, so we're not going to keep that card. We are going to then go ahead and spend our 8 heat to bump the temperature up 1, bumping our number there. We're going to go ahead and play our 8 plants to put another greenery tile down, which we'll place here to get 2 more plants on our player board. At this time, the temperature is at negative 16, which has not unlocked any of the other cards that we had previously, but we can, if we wanted to, place this card down, giving us another greenery tile, which now I'm wondering, did I bump up the temperature? I don't believe I did. So let's bump the temperature up for that. The oxygen. Let's spend the 3 energy to do the bump of the oxygen there. It's going to bump us there. Let's see, we've done that twice. We've got 2 of those down. I know we've gotten oxygen from something else. I think we're at 6, and I'm wrong on that, I apologize, but I believe that's where we're at on our oxygen. So I do think I did forget to do that when I placed that last greenery tile down. We really need ocean tiles down. We really need the temperature to go up. Let's think about placing this Mohole Arena, which we will do for $20 in cash. And we will place it. It says increase your heat production by 4 steps and place this on an area reserved for an ocean. So we're going to scale this up to 10 heat we're going to produce every round. And we're going to place the Mohole in a spot reserved for oceans. We're going to get there. So we're going to get 2 titanium. Just in case a big titanium needing card comes up, we'll have it when we're ready to go. We now have $16 in cash. It costs 18 to do the ocean tile. We're going to convert 2 of these over to money from our action. We're going to spend that 18 to place another ocean tile down, bumping our terraforming rating up to 29. And we'll place the ocean tile here to give us 2 plants. Cannot do anything else. We don't have enough cash. We don't have anything else to do it, but we are ready for the next round. But also, don't forget that because we placed an ocean tile down, we do get 2 plants. So we could actually do this 2, 4, 6, 8. We're actually going to do that now. Unfortunately, I said the round was over. It's not. We're going to go ahead and place another greenery tile, bumping our oxygen, bumping our terraforming rating, and placing greenery tile down. We're going to place it here for 2 more plant life. And now the round is over. We're going to bump the round marker up to 11. We're going to make 1 titanium. We're going to make 3 plants. We're going to bump that over to heat and make 10 heat and get 6 more energy. And we're going to make $29. and draw four more cards. We have Magnetic Field Generator, not beneficial for us in this game. Noctis City, not going to be beneficial. AI Central allows you to draw two cards. We only have one science card right now, not enough. And the producing of bacteria, which would bump our temperature up. I think we're going to be okay there, so we're not going to keep that card either. We're going to now have $29 in cash. We have plenty of other things. We don't have anything that we can really use at Titanium Force. We're going to spend one of our action cubes there. Look at the top card. Not going to be beneficial. Not going to keep it. We're going to go ahead and spend three of our energy to bump the oxygen track up one, which is going to go there, which is then going to bump us twice because we're going to bump the temperature track up one more to negative 14. The next thing we want to do is try to get the ocean tile down. Well, we do have three tiles down, excuse me. So we're going to do the nitrophilic moss now, which is going to cost us 8. So we're going to spend 10, get 2 back. To lose two of our plants currently, but we're going to bump 2 up on the plant production, which is going to be okay, I think, towards the end of the game, because we're going to need it a couple more times. We currently have 15, 16, 17. We had $21. Plus, we could have 3 more, so we have $24. We're going to convert those into money, which is doing that. We're going to play the Protected Valley for all of that money that we just got. It's going to bump our money production up 2, and we're going to get to place a greenery tile on the board on an area reserved for oceans, which we're going to place it here, which is going to give us $2 cash and 2 plants. And a bump on the oxygen track and a bump on the terraforming rating. At this point, we are basically done for the round. We don't have anything we can use the titanium for. That would be very beneficial, but we just don't have it. So we're going to end the round. We're going to bump it to round 12. We're going to get one more titanium. Oh, forgot to do this. Forgot to spend 10 of our heat, so let's go ahead and do that. 10 of our heat to pump up the temperature to 12 there. Okay? I didn't cheat, I promise. Getting our money, bumping that over, getting energy, getting plants. We already got our titanium. We're getting 1 plus 34, so $35 in cash. And 4 new cards. Solar wind power, which is going to give us some titanium and energy, which we don't really need at this point in the game, although we could use some of that titanium finally to play something. We have the immigrant city, which is going to just give us some stuff for placing a city down. We have hackers, which is not going to do very much for us except take away points. And we have urbanized area, which is not going to do very much for us either. We can look at keeping the solar wind power just to get the titanium, but we're going to be spending titanium for it. I don't think I want to do that. I'd rather keep my cash. We're going to remove our action tiles, but we're going to do our action to draw the top card to look at to see if we want to keep it. It's grass, which I think we will keep, so we're going to spend $3 to keep that. Still need to find something to do the titanium with, but just it hasn't come up for us yet. We will then go ahead and play grass, because we can, because the temperature is above negative 16, which is going to bump our production of plants up to 6. And give us 3 immediate plants, which is more than enough. So we're going to spend 8 plants to go up one on the oxygen and place a greenery tile down. We'll place the greenery tile here to give us $2 and 1 plant. Because again, we're placing it next to an ocean. So when you place it next to an ocean, you get $2 for each ocean you're touching. We're not quite to negative 8 on the temperature, but we're going to make it a little bit closer. We're going to bump that temperature up one more. And bump our terraforming rating up 1. So we're at negative 10. We would certainly like to be able to get it to negative 8 so we could do the permafrost extraction. So we'll go ahead and spend 14, which is the cost to do an asteroid action, one of the standard projects, to just bump it up manually. So far, if you haven't been counting, I think we've only done 2 of the standard projects, which is when I said when we would not keep the standard technology, did think it was going to be worth it. We now have the ability to play permafrost extraction, so we're going to go ahead and do that. We're going to spend the $8 cash and it's going to allow us to place an ocean tile. So we'll flip that card over. We're going to go up one of our terraforming rating. We're going to place an ocean tile on the board. We're going to place it here to get another card just because we're hoping we get a good card. Looks like we did get a very good card. And because we did an ocean tile and we have the effect here, we get two more plants, which is going to give us 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we're going to use the 8 that we have to place another greenery tile, which is going to bump our auction up to 11. That greenery tile we're going to place here for 1 plant and $2. We have 6 energy. We can bump up the oxygen track by utilizing 3 of that energy, but we'll see if we want to do anything different than that. The escape, the beam from thorium asteroid, which is fantastic, is going to cost us a lot of money, but we have 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, $21 currently in titanium alone, and this is a discount, so it's only going to be $29, and we have 21. So 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29. So let's spend turn 3 of those 6 into cash using our action here. And with the 21 plus our cash that we had exactly 29. So we're able to do the beam from the thorium asteroid. We do have a Jovian tag already. And we will spin this, play this card, bumping our heat production up to 13 and bumping our energy production up to 9. That is a green card, so it stays out. Currently, we're not able to do much else this round. Let's double check, look around. We did not place any more ocean tiles yet. We're okay there. We're good. I think we're done with this round. We're going to go to round 13. We're now going to produce 1 titanium. We're going to produce 6 plant. We're going to move that over to heat and produce 9 energy. We're going to produce 13 heat. Now you may be wondering why I didn't use that 3 to do my action, which was to bump the auction up. We only need to bump it 1, 2, 3 more times, and I feel like we'll be able to do that without that need because of the greenery tiles we're going to be placing out. But we may not. We may not be able to do that, so we'll see. May have made a big mistake there, but we'll find out. Been making $39 this round. And drawing 4 cards. Open city, not really useful. This would give us more points in the game if we think we're gonna win. Asteroid's gonna do a little bit of good to do some things. And this is going to give us a little bit of good. Definitely not sure that I want to keep any of these cards for the amount of money it's going to cost us. So we're not going to keep any. Again, I could have maybe maximized my points if I were able to know I was going to win and then use some of those cards, but I'm not positive I'm going to win. So I'm not going to keep those cards. Simple as that. I'm going to spend 10, using 8 to bump up the temperature up to negative 6. We're going to see how much money or heat we have now. 2, 4, 6... 8. So we're going to do the heat one more time. Goes up to negative 4. And we bump up our terraform rating, of course. We have 2, 4, 6 heat right now, but we have 9 energy. We have 7 plants, which is not enough to do the bumping. So we're going to go ahead and spend 3 of our energy for our action here to bump the auction up by itself. Going up to 41. We now need to place as many oceans as we can. If we can get the temperature up to 0 degrees, we'll be able to place 2 oceans because of this card right here if we're able to play it. So let's see how much money we have. We have, we need 24. So we're going to spend 24 to bump up twice on the temperature. 1, 2, which places an ocean tile. Place it here for 2 plants. And because we place an ocean tile there, and we get 2 more plants because of our Arctic algae, we're going to go ahead and place the greenery tile down, which we'll place it here to give us 2 more plants and $2. Now we have 0 degrees, so we want to play the Lake Marineris, which is going to cost us 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. It's going to cost us 18. So we're going to go ahead and convert all of this into cash, because I think we'll have enough heat to do what we need to do, or cash if we need it for the other way around. So we're going to do that. We're going to spend 18. Play the lake, which is going to place two ocean tiles. We're going to place two ocean tiles, so we're going to get four plants, which are going to convert that, just take away one. I'm going to go up twice in the terraforming rating and place two ocean tiles down. Let's place a tile there to give us $4, and a tile there to give us $2 and a plant. So one plant and $6 cash. We've got enough to place another greenery tile down, which is going to bump our oxygen up and that up. Place our greenery tile here to get one more plant and $4, because it's only next to two ocean tiles. We now have $15. Sorry, miscounted there. Not a very good counter, I guess. We have 15, so let's go ahead and bump up let's do our action to draw a card and look at it. I hadn't done that yet. Nah, useless. Let's go ahead and bump up the temperature one more to make it to positive 2 degrees. And bump up our terraform rating one. We're now going to the final round. We're going to produce a lot of stuff this round. Let's do this. It's 13 heat. 9 energy, which that energy is going to be pretty much wasted, which is why I went ahead and converted the other to cash. It may have been better to leave it for heat production, but I think we're going to be okay there. One more titanium. We're up at $47 for making in cash this round. And we'll draw 4 cards. So we've got that car, Olympus Conference, not going to keep. Caretaker contract, if we have a lot of heat left over, which I don't think we're going to, we could have converted that to points. Not going to be happening. We don't really need the heather because we've got enough plants and we don't need it for the oxygen. And the bribe committee, which would give us 2 points and take away 2 points. Again, not worth it. Not going to do any of those cards. First thing we're going to do is look at the top card to see if we want to pay for it or not. Deep well heating. Yes, I think it's worth it because it's going to save us some money. We're going to spend $3 to keep it. It saves us $3. It only costs us 10. We're going to spend $10. Literally, it's going to save us $1 on doing the asteroid, but that's okay. Go up one on the energy, and we're going to bump the temperature up 2+4. Again, it saved us literally $1 to do it that way, but that's okay. Ice cap melting, we're going to spend $5 cash to do this. We're going to flip that over, spend the $5. We get to place an ocean tile on the board, which we're going to do. And we will place it here for $2 and a plant. We have enough plants. We're going to spend 8 plants for a greenery tile. That greenery tile is going to go here for $6 and 2 plants. And we bump the oxygen, and we bump our money up to, or our terraforming rating up to there. We need to do one more ocean, and we did an ocean, so we should have gotten two more plants. I might have been missing that, but I don't think we really needed it. We don't need to bump the oxygen, so we don't need to do this action. That's been helping us, but not a whole lot, and we definitely don't need to do this. There's no reason to, but we can anyway. We might as well. So we're going to get $9 in cash. I mean, there's really no reason to have energy at this point. Let's do the temperature up twice, which is going to cost us 16. So let's just go ahead and pay all of it at once. So we're bumping it up twice, 2+8, going up to 51. The only thing we have to do now is play an ocean tile down, which we currently have well enough money. So we'll spend the 18 to place an ocean tile on the board, bumping us up to 52 points. And we will place it in the only, there's only two remaining places to put it. So we're going to put it here to get the $2 extra bucks and one plant. We have 2, 4, 6, 7 plants, not enough to do a plant life place. Do not have enough to do that. We definitely don't have enough to do much else, but we have a lot of cash, so we did place that ocean, so we do have enough, because we get the 2 for that the algae. So 2, 6, 7, 8. So we'll place another greenery tile down. These are all points now at the end of the game that we're just grabbing for this. So where could we put it to get us the most points? Let's place it here to get 2 more plants, 4 more bucks. And we can do a city probably at this point. Where would be the most points for the city that we place? We want to place it touching as many of our plant our greeneries as we can. Okay, let's see about this. So if we pay 10, 20, 5 is the cost. So we'll spend that. Basically, we're just spending that 25 bucks. We're not going to put it in a pile because that's pretty much all we're going to be doing. To go up one on that and to place a city tile down. We'll place a city tile down here. Not that I necessarily know that's the best place or the most obvious place. It's just, I'm just going to place it there because that's where I want to do it. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 bucks in cash. Not enough to do anything else. The round's over. We will produce, which we're going to get 6 more plants, which is going to be enough to spend to do one more greenery tile, which we'll place here. And that'll be the end of the game. We did get finished with everything. We got all the stuff done. We won the game. We won, 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 won. We win. We win, we win, we win, we win, we win. Fantastic, great things. Now let's just see how many points we get. So right now we currently have 52 bucks, or 52 points, excuse me. And we're going to count up the number of greenery tiles and then count up the amount that our city's worth and then all the cards we have. So let's just do the greenery tiles first. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So we go up to 63. This city is worth 1, 2, 3, so we go up to 66. And then we just count up the points that are on our cards, which we don't have many, but we have 2, 3, 4, 5, and the events. Just 5 more. So we go up to 71 points. Respectable 71 points victory with the Thorgate Corporation. Thanks for watching, guys. I was able to get a successful win out of the Thorgate, and I'm happy about it. I think I was able to work the energy utilization. I may have been able to do better with the keeping of the cards from that other from the business network, but I wasn't really doing that very much. But maybe I should have. I did end up with some cash left over. Didn't really end up with much else left over, which was a good. Kind of glad about that. But overall, a good win. 71 points is not bad at all. And thanks for watching, and I'll have another one of these here soon. Thanks, guys.